Welcome back to DIY with Nancy. We're going to be making massages today. First, I just want to thank everybody for all your love and support. It means a lot. With regards to the massage, it's basically a Portuguese donut. I'm going to be posting all the ingredients as well as the recipe. And if you decide to go ahead and try the recipe, please tag me on Instagram or on Facebook. With a photo, any questions. If you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Let's get to baking. First, we're gonna start off with the yeast. So you can let the yeast rise and put it aside while you put in the other ingredients together. So I'm gonna first start off with the flour. So I'm gonna put the flour in the bowl. Then I'm gonna put the sugar. And then I'm gonna put the yeast. Okay, so now we're gonna add the warm water. Pour it in, and we're gonna mix it. Just keep mixing until it's incorporated. Okay, now we're gonna be putting the milk in the pot. Try not to get it splashed on you. And then we're going to be putting the butter into the pot with the milk. Okay, now we're going to turn on the stove, leave it on low, let the butter melt. Don't let it boil, just as long as the butter's melted, it's ready to go. And if you saw my last video, you'll see it's a similar step. Okay, now for the fun part. We're going to be putting in the eggs in the mixer. We're gonna put the sugar. And we're gonna put in the lemon zest. And the salt. We're gonna add the whisk onto the blender. I'm gonna lock it. Then I'm gonna put it on and stir it off. I'm ready to blend. I'll just put on four, like a medium speed. You let that go on for a minute and then you increase the speed, just a little bit more. Okay, now that the milk and the butter are warm and not boiling, you're gonna pour it into the blender slowly. And keep mixing it. And let that blend for about 30 seconds to 45 seconds. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I've stopped it. I'm gonna pour this mixture into a larger bowl, and then I'm gonna add the yeast and the flour. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pour this mixture into a larger bowl. It's all in there. And then I'm going to get yeast that's frozen. And I'm going to pour it into this mixture here. Pour it all out of the bowl. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the flour in and I'm going to knead it all with my hands. Warm water, and I just set aside while I start kneading. In the end, you'll see that I'm gonna dip my hands in there, and so it can stay less sticky, I'm gonna incorporate it with my hands. Here we go. The heat in so the dough can rise. I'm gonna really seal this good. I'm using two tablecloths. And I'm gonna be back in about half an hour to knead it again. And that's it for now. After approximately 30 minutes of letting the dough rise, you're going to knead it again for about 30 seconds. Dip your hands in the warm water and knead it, and then cover it up again. So now you're gonna let it sit for about another 60 minutes or so. Yeah, you got that yummy, yummy. Melissades, you want to get yourself prepared by placing a fried pan with vegetable oil in it, and also having some platters here with some paper towel, and then I also have a tong, and as well on the side here I have some milk in the bowl, so that way I can dip my hands in while I'm stirring the melissada dough before frying. And then here in this bowl I have about 2 to 2.5 cups of sugar, so I can roll the melissadas in there once they're done. So I'm going to start off by first testing the oil to make sure it's hot. And the way you know it's hot is I'm just going to tear a little bit of this here, this dough, and I'm going to throw it into the fry pan, see if it bounces back up. And there you go. And you know the oil is ready for the melissadas. I'm going to start off by dipping my hands into the milk. And then I'm going to tear a piece of the melissada dough. Make sure that your hands are quite wet. So I'm going to stretch it out almost like a little pie. Just stretch it as much as it can. And then you're pretty much gonna throw it into the deep fryer. And you can do about 2 or 3 of these, or even 4. Make sure that the oil is not too hot so it doesn't burn. And you're gonna have to keep a close eye on it. And I'm gonna start off by, after I put this one in, I'm gonna check on the first one. And it's already browning, these are quite quick. Keep going. And it's okay if there's like a little hole in it. It's gonna fry anyway. It's not what they look like, it's what they taste like. Dipping the melissadas into the sugar and just dipping them in with a generous amount of sugar, and then you just let them stand.